Good evening, this is Diparani Hijam giving you the ISTV evening news. First, the headlines. Passengers and drivers are facing immense problems and difficulties on National Highway 53. And Paramban vendors observe one-day protest against artificial price rise. Now the news in details. Passengers and drivers traveling along the National Highway 53 are facing immense problems and difficulties due to the precarious conditions of the highway. Even small children are not spared. We have a report on the actual conditions of the suffering passengers and drivers along the highway of the 21st century.
Drivers braving all sorts of suffering and problems to meet the daily requirement of more than 25 lakh people of the state, as well as the passengers traveling along the National Highway No. 53, are facing untold miseries and difficulties due to the extreme condition of the highway. Drivers who were bringing in food and other essential items for the whole population were still left to mercy and fate. Many of the drivers who were stranded on the highway spent more than 10 to 20 days without proper food, water, with no sign of defense against malaria. Many trucks were still dumped and parts of the vehicle were either broken or damaged, not to speak about the physical injuries inflicted to them. The drivers lamented the inaction on the part of the state government for not developing and making the highway so that drivers could ply without any artificial problems and difficulties. They also expressed the need to inquire about the work taken up by the concerned authority.
अरे मसी कमाई तो न छूसी गे कमाई तो न फगलन जी गे है बसी डिपार्टमेंट की इंक्वायरी फिल इंक्वायरी में चंगन बता में कोई
ऑन द अदर हैंड मेनी पैसेंजर्स वर आल्सो इनकाउंटरिंग अनटोल्ड मिजरीज एंड प्रॉब्लम्स ए स्टूडेंट हु केम टू टेक पार्ट इन द एमबीबीएस एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ नाइग्रिम्स एट शिलोंग कर्स हर फेट एज शी वाज स्ट्रैंडेड ऑन द हाईवे फॉर मोर देन 7 डेज A woman, along with her two children, who came to Usatol to meet husband, spent more than 7 days inside the truck without any hope. She castigated the state minister for not developing the road. Roadside vendors along the highway have to tread on the muddy road with items on their head to procure from Ziribam. A woman along with her in-laws, who could reach Silsar in 2 days only, has to spend more than 15 days facing all sorts of inconveniences and problems. They feel that what had befell to them should not be happened to any other, and sought the government attention so that passengers and driver travel along this highway without any man-made problem. With cameraman Gagan Sama, this is Sajan Rumna, reporting for ISTB English News.
Women vendors of Kwaramban Kaitel today observe one-day protest against the artificial price rise in the state. Women vendors off their normal activities and the shops and business establishment in the bazaar area also down shutters as part of the protest. Despite the suspension of the economic blockade on the highways of the state, yet the people of the state are getting and buying all the essential items at an inflated and exorbitant price. The women folk blame the artificial price rise as a result of the unholy nexus between businessmen and the government. They also allege the government is responsible for making the lives of the common people very hard. In connections with the protest, Nupi Kaitel Maruk, Nupi Kaitel Semgat Sagat Palup, and the Nupi Kaitel Sinfam Amadi Saktam Kanbalup also hold a public meeting, and the sit-in protest were staged in many areas of the market. Those who spoke in connections with the protest slay the state government of remaining like a silent spectator, even if businessmen sold all the essential items at an inflated rate. Drawing the attention of the government to control the price, they urge to fix the price. Castigating the government for maintaining that enough petrol stock is not available, though huge quantities of petrol were found from second MR area. They urged the government to understand the suffering of the people. Taking a dig to the UGs in the state for remaining indifferent to the problems, they asserted that mothers are not satisfied to their silence. Similar protests were also observed in front of Uripok Charap Court and Nagamapal. Placards denouncing the increase in the price and the ineffectiveness of the government were used in the protest. Unidentified persons today planted a bomb at the Kaira residence of MOBC Minister Muhammad Alauddin Khan. Police retrieved the bomb safely. On the other hand, a bomb was also planted at Waheng Lekai residence of Soyam Chandrakumar around 9 a.m. today. The bomb was planted by two unidentified persons who came to the residence of the Chandrakumar, who is serving as a head clerk in the Social Welfare Department. The bomb was safely retrieved from the spot by the police. A member of the family appealed to the concerned not to repeat such act in the future. Ichem President Ann Boy yesterday inaugurated a weekly market shed at Kampang Kulen and Chandel District. The Friday weekly market of the Eastern Maring was constructed jointly by Ichem and the Eastern Maring at the cost of 4 lakhs. Ichem Advisor Simre, Office Secretary Jinjoy and the 18 village chiefs of Eastern Maring were also present in the ceremony. Speaking on the occasion, Ichem President Ann Boy observed that this unity among the various ethnic communities in the state is responsible for lack of development and the call for oneness among all the communities. A non-Manipuri was found dead at Kongba Nongthombam Lekai today in the morning. He was found shot dead near BC Academy. Locals could hear 4 rounds of gunfire last night. Police pick up the dead body and deposited at Rims Morgue for identification. It is not clear who killed him. Employees of the Electricity Department today met Chief Minister in connections with the exalt of SES Joykumar by MLA Meghachandra of Wangkhem Assembly Constituency. According to the staff, MLA should apologize to the engineer for what he did yesterday. He also said the employers' union will launch benefiting agitations according to the action taken up with the chief minister. On the other hand, a sit-in protest was staged at Brahmapur Aribam Laika Youth Club building in protest against the exalt.